had to do it. Well, it was quite a nice place, but the facilities aren't very good. There was one time when there was a shit on the floor, and it was there for 5 days before it was cleaned up. That's my favourite memory of Burrell. Is that right?
Burrell's that really skanky, ugly building which you don't want to associate with, but it's definitely home. It grows on you like a mould.
And do you have any specific memories from your time there?
Mostly of other people being drunk. Danny passing out, drawing dicks on him.
And
a marker.
People around here affectionately call you darling. Is there a reason for that?
Yeah, there's two possibilities. One, when we all sat around and decided I was the cutest, so I got darling. Or, and somebody thought this one up, if I went to prison, I'd be the one that got butt raped and people were darling.
I can't do it.
Do you have any fond memories of your time in Burrell?
The time I was found on the toilet, asleep. That wasn't a fond memory.
Some people have mentioned of a certain incident that happened in KFC. Would you like to shed some light?
KFC, it was in Burger King. Well, basically, what happened was I'd been drinking heavily for a couple of days. I was a little bit unwell. I went to Burger King and I ate too much. And I went outside and I was going to fart. But it wasn't a fart. So I went to the toilet. And I went to the toilet and I tried to clean myself up, but there were no bins to put my underwear in. So I had to come out of the, because I don't want to leave it on the floor for the cleaning ladies to sort out. So I took it out, went into the main dining room. At this point, Zach and Todd saw me, and they're like, "What's happening, Dave?" So I shut myself, and we went to the bin, put it in the main bin. And I was just stunk pretty bad for the restaurant. I just went home, had a shower, go on with my life.
Yeah, oh my God, can we say that, please? One of the best memories of Burrell,
yeah, oh my God,
is that me and Lauren were in the toilet. Right, you tell her.
No, I don't.
Lauren got some texts from Pablo
saying, oh my God, get out, there's too many girls in here.
And we were like, what's going on? Like, what is he talking about? We were drunk, but this was like a Burrell drinking thing. And like, there was loads of girls in the toilet, like Russ's friends. And then we were like, what is he on about? And then I looked under the door, and I was like, there's a man in there.
And then I looked under and I was like, that's Pablo's shoes.
And then we were like, Pablo? And he was like, yeah.
He came out and he was just like that.
Basically, I was doing shit in the toilet.
The girls' toilet.
And then girls.
And there was loads of girls in there, and it was so
And you were
funny.
Really embarrassed.
That was you one of the best memories.
Yeah.
What would you say your favourite memory of your time in Burrell is?
Catchphrase in general is probably my favourite memory of Burrell. Just the whole idea of catchphrase as an entity on its own. Like, it started off at the beginning and we only had about two channels on the shit TV. And one of them basically showed catchphrase all the time. Like, nothing other than catchphrase in the Crystal Maze. And it's been a good year.
My favourite Burrell memory has to be when, on the first day, when we all sat in the living room, sort of all sat around very awkwardly, and we didn't really know each other, and sort of nice thinking about that, we didn't really know each other then, but sort of looking back now, we're sort of all good friends. And when you, John Taylor, walking out of your room, pissed as fuck, tripped up and fell on your head, and I had to take you to the toilet, and you threw up my shoe, but I don't care too much.
That.
Any specific memories? Christmas party was good. Christmas party was really good. Our Secret Santa. That was awesome. I don't know. Just generally the Burrell house party. It was a good time.
And do you have any specific memories of Burrell?
It's been quite a lot. There's all the parties, all the good parties that we've had.
We like the Burrell house party. Drinking here is always the best night.
I'm supposed to be locked up too. You escape, but I escape. You be in Paris getting fucked up too. Let's get faded. Lobberies for like 6 days. Gold bottles, soul models, spilling ace on my sick case. Also, her bitch behave. Just might let you meet gay. Shot towns, B Rose, moving the next BK. Also, her motherfucker.
That shit crack. That shit crack. That shit crack.
My name's Devin, and I accept.
That shit crack.
Oh, Jack.
Yes, sir.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about... Why don't you tell us a little bit about your experiences in Burrell?
I've really enjoyed Burrell, and although there's been loads of good parties and stuff, and I mean, shouting that guy over there, generally sort of dropping stuff out the window. And playing a lot of FIFA, just dusting around really. It's been really good. Heading to the beach, it's always good.
Some people have said that you've gotten Swansea to the Champions League.
I mean, that is true. Yeah, I did do that. Made some good signings, you know, good tactics. That's all I can say really. I mean, I'm now Arsenal manager, moved up a little bit. And, I'm just continuing my career from there, really.
When I first heard I was living in Burrell, I was devastated. It was not what I wanted. But after letting people into my comfort zone, after a few weeks, it takes time, I see all the benefits and I realise there's nowhere else to be. Activities such as going to the bookies with the lads, obviously meeting the lovely Lauren, and just smoking a J on the common, going to the beach, just makes me realise sometimes that there are things in life that people won't experience by not living in Burrell.
I think what Burrell means to me is it's like a stepping stone from childhood into our adult years, I like to think. Probably the first time most of us have been away from our parents. Didn't really know what to do, but I like to think as president I've been a father to most of you. You know, one of my proudest moments is when John Taylor, 3 months in or something, you came up to me and you said, you know, Pablo, you know, thank you for being there.
Mm.
Thank you for being someone I can hold on to when I'm in need. And I said, yeah, that's fine. Fine, you know, that's what I'm here for. And then you said, you know, Pablo, do you ever think about yourself? And I was like, nah, not me, no. Always thinking about others, me. I mean, table tennis table, it's all me, that's my legacy. There was that time when we served, wow, the kitchen serves chicken Kievs.
Yep.
I asked them to do that, you know,
So I'm quite happy about that. About my legacy as president. I like to think I've made people's life a lot better. And I know I have. You know, you've all been great to me. And it's the least I can give back, really. So, yeah. So I love you lot. Most of you, you know. Not the fat ones, I don't like the fat ones.
Do you think you're going to miss Burrell next year?
No.
We're gonna cry, we're gonna come party, we're gonna come back, we're gonna be drunk, we're gonna miss the nights, we're gonna miss the noise, just constant noise. There's always someone
everyone
here
together.
To talk to. Like, you can go anywhere, like Jack's room, Lauren's room, Alex's room, Cass's room, Pablo's room, Kylie's room.
We're gonna miss these thin walls.
Yeah, miss the thin walls,
miss
like
really
they
thin
move,
walls that you
which
can
is
hear.
Really cool. yeah. Like people coming back drunk and like
just
we can look outside our window. The peepholes,
oh,
right?
Oh yeah,
they're fun.
Oh, the sickle over
here's
the floor.
Coming yeah, the sickle over the floor. Shit's in the toilet, not in ours. But you know,
until Pablo's in there.
Yeah.
Burrell is amazing, and I'm happy that I met all my friends there. It's really good.
I'm gonna miss the people of Burrell, definitely. More than anything.
But not the building.
Maybe the free food.
Yeah, I won't be the same. It's just this section here will just be missing. Just this bit here. It's like an Indiana Jones, the second one, where he basically reaches in and grabs his heart. And that's what it'll be like. Just a massive hole in my chest.
I love Burrell.